I watch Hello Okanagan from Penticton.
Hey guys, we've got some brand new merch here, the Hello Okanagan gear. Peter, where do they find it?
HelloOkanagan.com. There's t-shirts, hoodies, sweatshirts, coffee mugs, everything. And if it's not there, write Brad and tell him you want it. Hey everyone, guess what? Everyone's been telling us about Naramata Bench Wineries, and we're here. Where is the first place we're going to?
First stop is here at La Frenz. We're very excited to check this out and do some day drinking.
Subscribe.
We got a lot of stuff planned for us today, so we got to get going, but we'll be back and enjoy this wonderful view here at the Lakeside Resort.
Yeah, we'll be back at 11 p.m. just in time to go to sleep.
Friends in 1998, and my dad is a formally trained winemaker from Australia.
Where did the name come from?
You know what, it's an old family name.
How many different types of grapes do you do here?
On this actual property is about 5 different grapes, but to be honest, we do a ton of grapes. I can't even list all of them. So we do Sauv Blanc, Semillon, Viognier, Chardonnay, like I said, 2 different types of Muscat varieties. As far as reds, it's Malbec, Merlot, Shiraz, Cab Franc, Cab Shiraz.
And walk us through the time now, like when do we start seeing the leaves, you know, get really big, and when do the grapes start?
Oh my gosh, so if you come back in a day, they're going to be...
In a day?
Honestly, right now, bananas. They just grow so quickly. So these, a week ago, were tiny. Cheers!
I always jump when that happens.
It's a breakfast champagne.
I always love that.
So you're saying that so we don't feel bad that we're having booze first thing in the morning?
That's right. Trying to protect you.
You can drink it at any time though, it's not just for breakfast.
That's right, it's a Monday wine, a celebratory wine, a bit of anything, really.
As Peter would say,
every day is a celebratory day.
It's a Tuesday wine. You choose what day you want to drink it.
Chardonnay is grown across the road in our Freedom 75 vineyard. It's planted in 2012.
What's it called, the vineyard?
Freedom 75.
Wasn't it Freedom 55 back in the day? Now you got to wait till you're 75 so you can retire?
That's it. We're keeping with the times. Yeah. And then the Pinot Noir is grown at our Desperation Hill vineyard. So it's just a little bit further along in Naramata. You'll drive right by it today. And it's totally dedicated to Pinot Noir.
So how many off-site location vineyards do you have?
So we have 5 vineyards total, and 4 of which are on the Naramata Bench.
Do you guys grow all of your grapes for your own production, or do you actually export or outsource any of your production as well?
We're considered a medium-sized winery, and we grow 95% of our own grapes. So we have complete control over those, and we're able to tailor it all to the variety and the style that we're trying to make. Okay, so this is our Merlot. Have it planted at Freedom 75, the vineyard I just told you about across the road. It's a newer planting. And then this is Schomburger, but right in front of it is our original planting. And I told you my sister and I did a lot of the work and can remember the day we were planting that Merlot.
Must be special though, like years later now, what it's producing, knowing that you started it from the ground up.
Yeah.
The one thing that I like about the Naramata Bench Wineries is when we do wine tours, whether it's David and I on the show or with friends or whatever, they're so much closer than other wineries. So the region is nice and tight. So literally you're not going too far to the next winery, and it makes the trip a lot easier.
I mean, that's right. Like, you know, we're all neighbors. It is a friendly competition at the end of the day, and I think we're all in it together, and we really want people to come here and try our wines as a whole, because we're doing such wonderful things, and we're really at the beginning, just the beginning of our industry taking off. And the more people we can get here trying our wines, the exposure that we can have, the better.
Well, thank you. Cheers.
Absolutely. Cheers.
There, that's the money shot at the end there.
Hey guys, we're Naramata Bench Wineries, and we're going to another amazing winery. Where are we, David?
We're at D'Angelo Winery. Let's go.
Chris, the man himself, is already here to greet us.
Hey guys, how are you?
Good, Chris. How are you?
Thanks. Pretty good, thank you.
Thanks for allowing us to come down and see your property. So where do you want to show us first?
We can check out the tank room and do a little tasting of rosé. Check out the facility a little bit.
So you're twisting our rubber arms to try wine already?
I guess so. It's early.
You're a man after my own heart. Let's check it out. So Chris, where are you right now?
We're in the cellar here at the family winery on Naramata Bench. We've got roughly 120 barrels inside and outside at the moment.
Wow.
We take wines out of the barrel in the spring, and the 2020 that was made in the fall go into the barrel. So there's a barrel swap, some cleaning, some maintenance, and the wines that come out of the barrels get prepared for filtration and bottling. All right, so here we have a tank that's going to be, it's near ready to bottle. It's our 2020 rosé, done with the Signage method. So it's got some Merlot and Tempranillo. So have a taste. So as you can see, it's pretty clear already. It's been racked several times where we've settled the sediment. And it'll be filtered through a cross-flow filtration system.
And this is the final color that it'll be?
It will be a little more clear. Filtration does strip a little bit. You can't filter a wine and not have it strip a little bit of color and a little bit of, because it is filtration. But it is the best way to do it, in my opinion.
This is almost a different take on rosé, I feel like. It's a little bit bolder, if I can say, as opposed to light and fruity. Mm-hmm. I like it a lot more. I've become more of a red drinker, so I definitely I can feel the depth and the bold.
The blend helps with the complexity. There's a lot of different flavors going on.
What are we gonna taste here today?
Today we're gonna try our 2019 Viognier, which is grown here on the property. All of our wines, all the wine we make is grown on the property. We'll do our 2017 Pinot and our 2017 Septicopa. Septicopa is our Bordeaux blend. It incorporates Merlot, Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, Malbec, Petit Verdot.
Wow, this is almost clear, like water. Sorry, it's
very bright out right now, but if it was... Yeah, it does look like very clear at the moment. Cool. So you're gonna get some stone fruit, some citrus, and it is a bit off dry.
Get the sweetness too, it's really nice.
Oh, it is sweet.
With a nice acid to balance it, got some good backbone. So 2017 Pinot Noir, it's made in a traditional Burgundian style, barrel aged for about 18 months in neutral barrels.
Getting smoke and pepper.
That's a little bit from the oak barrels.
What are you pouring now?
So this is the 2017 Septicopa. Septicopa is actually a family name. In Italian, it means seven measures. It goes back to our great-great-grandfather, Donato.
And I can taste all of them.
keep that good.
Can you tell him what percentage goes into each bottle?
I cannot tell what percentage goes in. Oh, can he?
That's what I was saying. He says he can taste
the
each
fake
one.
Connoisseur. The fake connoisseur.
The winemaker can't even tell. The season changes every year. The pH and TA, the titratable acidity, the physiology of the plant, every year is a little bit different according to what we were just talking about with the weather and everything like that. So the percentages and the, they're actually different every year.
One thing's for sure, after trying all these wines, you definitely have to try out D'Angelo Winery if you are in the Naramata Bench. So thank you so much, Chris, for your time today and for showing us around. Very wicked operation you guys have here, and I love the story and the family component. So thank you for sharing that with us today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Salute.
And now it's time for an Okanagan update
with Elizabeth Flowers.
Hello, Okanagan. I'm Elizabeth Flowers, and here is your Okanagan update. The Okanagan has a new adventure park that's opening this weekend. The Okanagan Adventure Park will be located at 5983 Highway 33 in Kelowna, and they're gonna celebrate opening weekend with a wicked special. Receive 2-for-1 on your entire booking when you use the code BOGOPOGO. This is valid until July 18th. They have an aerial adventure course, zip lines, a giant swing, and so much more. Stop on by OkanaganAdventurePark.com for more information. It's Sunday Fun Day at the Okanagan Heritage Museum all summer long. Drop in each week and discover something new. From 12 noon until 4 p.m., what's on the schedule this week? July 11th is all about owls, so you'll have a hoot during Owl Day. Look at talons and beaks up close and discover what owls eat by looking at a partially dissected owl pellet. And a reminder that there is a fire ban across the Okanagan, so let's all do our part to keep our environment safe. For a more up-to-date listing of what's happening around town, you can check out CastNet's event page. That's all for this week's Okanagan Update, and now we'll go back to the episode.
Hey guys, make sure you smash a like down there.
And make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, it really helps us out a lot. Subscribe, the big red button.
Hey everyone, we're at another winery here at the Naramata Bench area. David, where are we?
We're at Westbert Wineries.
Nice to meet you, Peter. Nice name.
Nice to meet you, Peter. Here for a tasting?
Yes.
Come on by.
Let's go.
So where are you from originally?
South Africa.
And when did you come out to the Okanagan?
2019. This was supposed to be a five-year project, doing a few courses at the college, but then we saw this property up for sale and we're like, why not? Let's jump in and let's do this. We are family owned and operated. For the family members that can't be with us, we decided we will name the blended wines for them. And that's where Adelaide White comes from, the first one that you will be tasting today, named for my mother.
And is everything made here and bottled here on this location, or do you have another location?
We do have other locations as well. We've got this 2.2 acres planted on this side, another 4.3 acres on the closer to Naramata, and then we do custom crush, be cool to get at other wineries as well.
Actually, this is very Okanagan, because Okanagan, people need to understand, it's warm, it's gorgeous, scenery is amazing.
Next we'll be having the rosé, 100% Merlot. Beautiful pink color, vibrant. For me, coming from South Africa, I'm used to sweet pink rosés, and that's what I like. Last but not least is the Gamay. A little bit heavier than the Merlot at this stage. It's 12 months in oak, 12 months stainless steel, blended together, and you get a nice fruity jammy.
Really good combination all around, really good depth of flavors. I think this is definitely a must try, absolutely.
Yeah, definitely, there wasn't a, and we're being honest to our viewers as well, there wasn't a bad one here as far as I'm concerned.
Nope. It wasn't a matter of which one did you like, which one did you not like, is which one did you like a little more than the rest.
Yeah. So.
We're trying to hit a bunch of wineries all at once. It's our first trip to Naramata, awesome. But so many people, whether they wrote us on our social media, we told it we were coming down here, said you have to visit.
So you start everyone off with some bubbles when they
always
first come in?
Everyone's hot.
Start the party.
Yeah. Yeah. We make Peter bubbles out of Pinot Noir, Pinot Meunier.
So we had the nickel, now we're having the dime, right?
Exactly. Yeah. We'll pour you our old vine Syrah. This is the oldest Syrah vineyard planted in Canada.
In Canada?
Planted in 1990, 1991. It doesn't seem very old, but we're a fairly young wine region. And it's planted just around the corner from us here. So all of our reds come from this 4.5 acres that are surrounding us.
And it's cooled right to the right temperature. I like that. It's not too warm.
It gets hot in the summer.
Yeah.
You have to keep it at cellar temp.
Yeah. If you guys are ever down in Naramata, Nichol Vineyard.
Guys, the bus is leaving. We gotta go to the next winery. Come on.
Okay, we're down at Daydreamer Wines with our Australian buddy, Marcus. Marcus, thank you for allowing us to come here.
Oh, my pleasure. Absolutely. I thought we'd try a couple of wines today. We've got our cuvée, which is made from Pinot Noir and Chardonnay from the property here. And it's a...
what a unique label.
Yeah, so that's actually my family crest.
Wow.
So...
Well, if it's as good as your beard, I think we're in for a treat.
So, yeah, this is Pinot Noir and Chardonnay, traditional method. Been in barrel for about a year, and then
you say traditional method.
Yeah, so traditional kind of champagne method. So basically, the secondary fermentation happens in the bottle. So you have a primary fermentation, which is in a barrel. Then we put it into a bottle and it undergoes a secondary ferment, and then we get rid of the yeast called disgorging, and then you end up with a nice bubbly wine. So we name the red wines after my kids. Tay, Amelia, and Jasper. So this is Amelia. This is actually a co-ferment of Syrah and Viognier. And this is probably our most popular wine.
Do they argue with each other, or who has a better tasting name?
You know, it's funny because sometimes the wines sell out sort of at different points in time, and they've got a little bit of a running competition on whose wine sells out faster.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Here, there's something about sheep here.
We do. We've got sheep. We run our vineyards organically, and we also have sheep that keep the weeds down.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Can we meet them?
So you got You got built-in lawnmowers.
You've got it.
Awesome.
Do they have names?
They do.
All right.
Yeah. Do you name the wine after them too?
Not yet. Not yet. But it's Jarrah, Maple, and Mugger are the three.
Mugger?
Mugger.
Like a mugger.
He's mugging you off.
But Australia, mugger.
He's going to mug you off. Talk about the uniqueness of the wineries in the Okanagan. We got sheep. So this is something your customers can just come up and hang out with.
They normally spend their days working in the vineyard, but occasionally they'll come up and say hi to the guests.
And they keep the lawn nice and smooth.
They do. We didn't have to mow the lawn once last year.
This has been a wrap. Our first visit to the Naramata Bench Wineries. We need to thank our tour guide, Hugh. Hugh, thank you so much.
Well, thank you guys for coming out. This is really great that you're exposing the Naramata Bench to the world through your show.
Well, so thanks a lot. We're just scratching the surface of what the area has to offer. So hopefully people know that there is so much more depth to the ones that we showed. But we did show as much diversity as we could in the area. So we're very, very pleased to have such a wonderful tour guide to help us out.
Oh, well, great. My pleasure. And please let people know. Come and join us anytime. We've got 28 wineries in total. Most of them are family run. like so many of the ones you've seen today. So,
and the cool part is everyone's got its own story. Everything has something unique, so it's not like you've been to one, you've been to them all.
It is definitely a variety. And it's an amazing variety in such a small space. It's really quite incredible.
Awesome. So what is there, almost 300 wineries in the Okanagan in whole, and we've scratched the surface, so we're going to have many more visits throughout the Okanagan. Make sure you come down to Naramata. Hey everyone, we got another amazing prize on our social media. Make sure you follow us on Facebook and Instagram. David, where are we?
Well, we're here at D'Angelo Winery, as you know, and Chris has an amazing prize he wants to talk about for you guys.
So we're going to give away a one-night free stay to our guest house here at the winery on the Naramata Bench. The guest house is located right on the vineyard and steps away from the winery, so you could come here, experience our winery, our family winery, and whatever else the bench has to offer.
Amazing. All right, guys, you know what to do. Head over to our social media, Facebook and Instagram. Turn on those post notifications so you do not miss it. You will definitely want to try to win this.
Make sure you do that now. You don't want to miss this.